That is so good.
Anything with egg, I'm in for. What's up everyone? I'm Chris. We've got Steph behind the camera and we're hungry to travel. We are in Georgetown, Penang, what many consider to be the food capital of Malaysia, and we're so excited to be here. The city has so many unique ethnicities and cultures that we're so excited to try all the different flavors and special dishes the city has to offer. This is a foodie heaven, so let's get going on this food tour.
Coconut tart.
Yes.
Oh, very cool.
I go step there. Come on, I'll bow your high seat.
The uncle here is saying that they make 700 of these coconut tarts every morning. Wow, so many.
Well, I do not buy them, I can't buy oil.
This shop has been around for over 120 years, so much history here in this building of selling biscuits and pastries. Oh wow. So many. Wow. Yeah. What would that be? Yeah. So It's just making the last layer now to go on top of the coconut tart. It's kind of like a walnut cookie. So cool and interesting. You just see the effort it takes going into these tarts, these handmade coconut tarts.
Wow, so beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Olang.
So they just put in a fresh handmade tray of the coconut tarts, and it takes about 15 minutes to cook them, so fairly quick to cook these little tarts. Can't wait to try them.
They're finished now. So nice and golden. You can really smell the coconut. Wow. Smells amazing.
So we have a fresh coconut tart here to try. Look how beautiful this looks. With the walnut biscuit on the top as well. Nice and golden, perfectly cooked, and piping hot.
Right out the oven.
It smells incredible, the coconut. You can really smell the coconut. They are hefty. Look at that. These are perfectly cooked. They're so nice, I don't even want to eat it. But here we go. Mmm, so hot, wow. Nice and coconutty, nice and crunchy. The walnut biscuit on the top is actually really crispy as well. The pastry is nice and flaky, buttery, just so fresh. Proseka, wow, so tasty. Mm. You can see all the coconut there too. Wow. See all the layers in there too, with starting with the walnut biscuit down into the gooey kind of center coconut and the flaky pastry here. You can really taste the history in these coconut tarts because this shop here has been around since 1900, so over 120 years. They're in the fourth generation now, so Sifu here and his daughters is teaching them the trade of how to make all of their biscuits here at the shop. You can really taste the handmade quality of these coconut tarts and all of their biscuits here that they sell. Mm. Truly amazing, wow. Hospitality here has been amazing. The kind auntie behind me here went to the next door shop to get us a coffee-o coffee to try with the coconut tart because she said you have to have one with a coffee. It just tastes amazing with the coffee. So they gave us another tart to try as well with a coffee. It's actually a bit chewy too in the center with all the coconut in there. Got a bit of a chewy texture, but oh, such amazing coconut flavor. Mm. Wow, that's an amazing combo. Mm. Oh wow. So delicious and yummy. What an experience. Thank you so much. Such amazing hospitality, wow. Bye-bye.
Penang has become known and famous for its street art installations. They were put in by Ernest Zakharevich back in 2012, and now they've become a part of the history of Georgetown. This is one of the most popular, famous, the boy on a motorbike. It's really, really cool how he's painted them on the buildings, but incorporated real life stuff with them. It's pretty awesome. Should we go for a ride, Lama? Really, really cool.
We're here now to try something that I know I'm gonna love, even though we haven't even tasted it yet, because it has eggs in it. Here to try a very popular Penang dish called oh-jian, and it's an oyster omelet packed with oysters. You probably put maybe 10 to 15 oysters in there, two eggs. Oh, this looks delicious. Nice big piece of egg. So right away I can taste the garlic flavor that he put in it. Oh. And it's actually less of like an egg taste because he only cracked two eggs in, and more kind of like a pancake because he mixes the egg with flour, so it actually has a more of like a chewier texture to it, like a pancake almost. Oh. Really tasty though, nice and crispy. See the sesame seeds in there with the garlic pieces as well. Get a try of these oysters. Super plump oysters, actually. Really big oysters. Nice and juicy and fresh oysters, wow. And you gotta have it with the oyster and the egg as well. That's a good combo. The oh-jian here comes in four different sizes, and we got the medium size. And to be honest, it tastes really good. I think it could use a little bit more egg in it because it has, like, again, that pancake taste. But for a medium size, there's, again, like 15 oysters in it. So super filled with oysters. Could use a bit more egg, but all in all, This is a really tasty dish. I'm gonna try an ultimate bite in the hot sauce and garlic as well. The ultimate bite. It's almost like a sweet and hot kind of chili sauce. That's really tasty with it, actually. Wow. Gives it a nice kind of hot kick to it. Mm. Anything with egg, I'm in for. Really tasty.
Hi, Saya.
Thank you.
Let's keep this food tour going.
Georgetown with all of its old historic buildings. Such a beautiful city to walk around. We're here to try Penang laksa. Now, laksa is found all over Malaysia, but here in Penang, they do it differently. It's called asam laksa, and it's made with tamarind. And this bowl that we've got here looks lovely. It's quite fresh with the lettuce. We've got mint, looks like some onion and different things. We've got these lovely rice noodles here. Look at that. I can smell how sour it is from that tamarind. Oh wow, that's so spicy. It's got a kick to it. You can definitely taste the sour tamarind in there. It almost tastes a bit like tomato-y as well. Interesting. The noodles are really, really nice, actually. They're nice, chubby noodles here. And they're nice and chewy. Really soak up the soup. It's a bit of a fishy broth there with mackerel in it as well as shrimp paste. So it gives it quite interesting, very fishy kind of flavor. But with the tamarind and the lemongrass, it really gives an interesting sour flavor too. There's lots and lots of flavor in this, and it's spicy. Ooh, it's so nice with the fresh lettuce, the mint, the zucchini, onions, lemongrass, everything. It's a really, really nice kind of fresh, crunchy texture with the chewy noodles. Ultimate bite. Penang is known for having lots of street food noodles, so I have a feeling this is gonna be the first of many. And this is a delicious way to start.
How many would you like, kids?
We're all out.
Okay.
4.
Thank you.
We're here on Penang Road to try the very famous Penang Road cendol. And it's a delicious bowl of shaved ice cendol goodness. You're supposed to mix it around. Now cendols are super popular dessert here in Malaysia. And it consists of shaved ice with red bean, brown sugar syrup, and this green stuff here is the cendol actually. So it's kind of like a green jelly, pandan jelly. So it gives it a cool, really nice gummy texture and looking color. And the main base of the cendol here is coconut milk. So it's got a whole ton of coconut milk in here. Wow, that is refreshing. Shaved ice instantly melts here. You can see there's still a big block of it though. But it's got such a nice flavor, creamy flavor from the coconut milk. Nice beany, kind of red bean chewiness. And the green cendol has a really funky, gummy texture. The flavor, like a sugary jelly. Mixed together with everything though, this is really nice, sweet, refreshing dessert. It's just the right amount of sweetness mixed with the creamy coconut milk. It's got a really nice flavor. Oh, look at that, a lot of red bean in there at the bottom of the bowl here. You see behind me here, they are pumping out bowls of cendol. There's always a lineup every single day at this hawker stall here for their famous cendol. And I can see why that it's so popular, because on hot days like today, this really does cool you down. Delicious.
Thank you. Thank you.
Let's continue on.
Good job, we've got these nice umbrellas to shade us from the sun. We're here at the New Lane Hawker Stalls for our last stop of the day, where we're going to be trying Penang's quite possibly most famous noodle, char kuey teow. Now, the asam laksa we had earlier was delicious, but this is a dried fried noodle, my favorite, so I'm really looking forward to this.
Wow.
Yeah,
go ahead. Go ahead, one go.
Alright, we've got our char kuey teow, and this is quite possibly one of the most popular noodle dishes in Southeast Asia. This looks amazing. We have got our noodles, bean sprouts. We got it with a duck egg, which I'm excited. I don't think I've ever had duck egg before. There is shrimp. We've got the lap churn Chinese sausage. The sifu making it was making it over charcoal, which gives it the wok hai, which is the breath of the wok. So it imparts really, really interesting flavor. So let's just dig in. Look at all these noodles. So good. You can seriously taste the breath of the wok, that wok hai. It imparts such a nice smoky flavor from the charcoal. That is insane. I love dry noodles like this. I'm in heaven right now. Mmm, so good. And there are so many ingredients here. So we've got the lap churn, the Chinese sausage. Nice and sweet, actually. That's really good. We got a ton of shrimp here as well. Look at these guys. And the egg? That is a big egg. There's chunks of it in here. Bean sprouts, also the fried lard. That is a plump shrimp. That is really good. Wow, he only put in one duck egg, but there's actually so much egg in here. Like, big, big chunks of egg. Cool. Really makes the whole dish a lot richer, I think, with that duck egg than a chicken egg. The flavor is so nice and rich with the dark soy sauce that he puts in, and just a little bit spicy with the amount of chili sauce that he puts in, just to give it a little bit of a kick. Look at that pork lard. The kuey teow actually refers to the noodles, which are rice noodles, and these are amazing. So delicious. Honestly, the flavors of Penang street food are just insane. So, so tasty. We wanted to come to this hawker stall specifically because the sifu makes his char kuey teow order by order, each one individually, so it makes sure that the flavors don't get diluted. And honestly, it tastes so good and so fresh. And he was saying that later on in the evening, there is a lineup of people waiting to get it because he does it in this traditional way. But I can see why people line up, because you really can't get much fresher and tastier than this. Have to come here. So good. That's it for our street food tour here in Georgetown, Penang. The food here really is next level. If you've enjoyed the video, give it a like. Let us know in the comments down below which food was your favorite. Make sure you subscribe to our channel to come on our next food adventure with us. We're hungry to travel, and we'll see you next meal.